हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। यू आर वेलकम इन दी वीडियो नंबर 9 ऑफ ए केमिकल थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इन दी वीडियो नंबर 8 वी हैव सीन फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड देन डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ प्रोसेसेस एंड द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। फॉर द फर्स्ट लॉ वी हैव स्टडीड फोर स्टेटमेंट्स, दैट इज फर्स्ट वन इज इट इज द लॉ ऑफ कॉन्जर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी, दैट इज एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉर डिस्ट्रॉयड, जस्ट वन फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू अनदर फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी एंड द टोटल क्वांटिटी ऑफ एनर्जी रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट बिकॉज इट इज कॉन्जर्वड। सेकेंडली वी हैव स्टडीड एनर्जी ऑफ यूनिवर्स रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट इरेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ different processes taking place in the universe. Then energy of an isolated system remain constant because isolated system is the system which will neither exchange energy nor matter with the surrounding. And at last, fourth statement we have seen, the summation of energy of a system and surrounding remain constant. Then formulation we have studied for the first law of thermodynamics, that equation is delta U is equal to Q plus W, where Q is heat absorbed by the system, W plus W, so that is the work of compression. Both are path functions and their summation is a state function, change in internal energy. And finally, we are arrived up to different type of processes and the first law of thermodynamics. Now the next point is enthalpy. The designation used for enthalpy is H. We know most of the chemical reactions are carried out in a open container in the laboratory. So, at all the corners of laboratory, external atmospheric pressure is same. Therefore, reactions are carried out at constant external atmospheric pressure. And they are carried out with a change in volume. Because we know, during expansion, the volume increases. Whereas during compression, the volume decreases. The reactions are carried out with change in volume and at constant pressure. The effect of constant pressure with a change in volume is given with the help of thermodynamic new state function known as enthalpy. It is given by the equation H will be equal to U plus PV. This enthalpy H is a summation of two energy terms, internal energy term and PV type of energy term. This internal energy is known as energy unavailable, not available to do work, and this is the energy available to do work. The summation of internal energy and PV type of energy is known as enthalpy of the system. Here we know internal energy U is a state function, pressure is a state function, volume is also a state function. Since all these three are state functions, therefore enthalpy H is also a state function. We know here delta U will be equal to U2 minus U1, delta P is equal to P2 minus P1, delta P will be equal to V2 minus P1. In the similar manner, since these three are the state functions, this is also a state function, and delta H will be equal to H2 minus H1, where H1 is enthalpy in the initial state of system and H2 is enthalpy in the final state of system. And the difference between enthalpy of final state and initial state is known as change in enthalpy, delta H, change in enthalpy. So how it can be calculated from this equation? Let us consider in the initial state of system, enthalpy in initial state will be equal to H1, internal energy in the initial state U1, pressure P1, volume V1. So from this equation, here we can write H1 is equal to U1 plus P1 V1. This is the expression for enthalpy in the initial state of system. Similarly, if we have H2 enthalpy in the final state of system, U2 internal energy in the final state, P2 is a pressure in the final state, P2 is volume in the final state of system. So from this equation, again, for a final state of system, we can write enthalpy H2 is equal to U2 plus P2 V2. Let this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now, change in enthalpy is this equation, delta H is equal to H2 minus H1. If we substitute H2 by this value, U2 plus P2 V2, and H1 by U1 plus P1 V1, we can write delta H is equal to H2, that is the value U2 plus P2 V2 minus H1. H1 will be minus, H1 is U1 plus P1 V1. Now solving the bracket, we can write delta H is equal to U2 plus P2 V2 minus U1 minus P1 V1. Now taking the similar terms together, we can write delta H is equal to U2 minus U1, U2 minus U1, then plus in another bracket P2 V2 minus P1 V1. We know U2 minus U1, this is nothing but delta U. Therefore, delta H is equal to delta U plus P2 V2 minus P1 V1. Now, we can write the pressure as P1 is equal to P2 is equal to P. Why P1 is equal to P2? Because at the start I have told you that the reactions are carried out in open container. They are carried out at constant pressure with a change in volume. Therefore, pressure in the initial state P1 is equal to pressure in the final state P2. Let us consider that is equal to P. But V1 and V2 are not same during the chemical reaction. Since that is carried out at constant pressure, pressure is constant but volume is not constant. So this equation now will become delta H is equal to delta U plus PV2 minus PV1. Now pressure is common there. Delta H is equal to delta U plus PV2 minus V1, and delta H is equal to delta U plus PV2 minus V1 is nothing but delta V. So it is P delta V. This is the equation for enthalpy change. This is the equation for enthalpy change during the chemical reaction. Enthalpy change in a process. Delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V. We have studied according to first law of thermodynamics, delta U is equal to Q plus W, where W is nothing but minus P delta V. Therefore, that equation is delta U is equal to Q minus P delta V, or Q will be equal to, what is it? डेल्टा यू प्लस पी डेल्टा बी. नाउ लेट दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर 3 एंड दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर 4. सी राइट साइड्स डेल्टा यू प्लस पी डेल्टा बी डेल्टा यू प्लस पी डेल्टा बी. सिंस राइट साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन 3 एंड द राइट साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन 4 इज सेम, देयर लेफ्ट साइड्स आर आल्सो सेम, therefore delta h will be equal to q at constant pressure. Enthalpy of reaction, enthalpy of process, enthalpy change of the process is nothing but the heat absorbed at constant pressure. So that is there about enthalpy. See it once again. Most of the chemical reactions are carried out in an open container, that is they are carried out at constant pressure and with change in volume. The effect of constant pressure is given with the help of thermodynamic state function enthalpy given by equation H is equal to U plus PV. Since U, P and V all three are state functions, therefore H is also a state function. So H can be calculated in terms of delta H equal to H2 minus H1, where H1 enthalpy in the initial state and H2 is enthalpy in the final state of system. From this equation, for the initial state H1 is equal to U1 plus P1V1, for the final state H2 is equal to U2 plus P2V2. Substituting equation 1 and 2 in this equation, we can get delta H is equal to H2 means U2 plus P2V2 minus H1 means U1 plus P1V1. Now solving the bracket, we will get U2 plus P2V2 minus U1 and minus P1V1. Now taking similar terms together, delta H is equal to U2 minus U1 plus P2V2 minus P1V1. U2 minus U1, it is nothing but delta U. Therefore, it becomes delta H is equal to delta U plus P2V2 minus P1V1. But P1 initial state pressure must be equal to final state pressure. Therefore, P1 is equal to P2. Let that is equal to P. So, P2 and P1 are replaced by P. This equation becomes delta H is equal to delta U plus PV2 minus PV1. Now, P is common. So, delta H is equal to delta U plus P, V2 minus P1. V2 minus P1 is nothing but a change in volume delta V. Therefore, delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta T. This is the equation for enthalpy change. For a first law of thermodynamics, we have studied this equation in the video number 8. Delta U is equal to Q plus W. W is nothing but minus P delta V. Therefore, delta U is equal to Q minus P delta V. From this, Q at constant pressure, maybe this is a Q. Here it is at constant pressure is equal to delta U plus P delta V. Since right side of this equation and right side of this equation are same, therefore their left sides are also same. Therefore delta H is equal to Q at constant pressure. Enthalpy change of the reaction is nothing but heat absorbed at constant pressure. Now see relation between delta H and delta U. Relation between delta H and delta U, that is heat of reaction at constant pressure and heat of reaction at constant volume. Just now we have seen this equation of enthalpy change, delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V. See, now relation between delta H and delta U we have to study for a chemical reaction, not for the process, for a chemical reaction. See what happened. This is the expression for enthalpy change, delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V.
Further, we have studied here delta H is equal to delta U plus P. Delta V means V2 minus V1. Again, one more step. It is delta H is equal to delta U plus P V2 minus P V1. Now, the ideal gas equation we have studied. What is the ideal gas equation? It is PV is equal to nRT. For the initial state, volume is V1, number of moles N1, RT, pressure is constant. Similarly, for the final state, volume is V2, number of moles will be equal to N2, so it is N2RT. So PV1 will be equal to N1RT, PV2 is equal to N2RT, substituting equation 1 and equation 2 in this equation. If we replace PV2 by N2RT and PV1 by N1RT, we can write this equation as delta H is equal to delta U plus N2RT minus N1RT. Now what is common over there? What is common in this bracket? RT is common. Taking the common, we can write this equation as delta H is equal to delta U plus N2 minus N1 RT. And N2 minus N1, it is the number of moles in final state minus number of moles in the initial state of a gaseous reactant or gaseous product. Therefore, this is a state function. So N2 minus N1 will be equal to delta N, and this equation become delta H is equal to delta U plus delta NRT. So this is the equation which use the relation between delta H and delta U for a chemical reaction. See it once again. Relation between heat of reaction at constant pressure, delta H, and the heat of reaction at constant volume, delta U, for a chemical reaction can be derived from the equation of enthalpy change, which we have studied. Delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V. Here delta V is V2 minus V1. So delta H is equal to delta U plus P V2 minus V1. Solving the bracket, delta H is equal to delta U plus P V2 minus P V1. Since ideal gas equation is PV is equal to nRT, for initial state PV1 is equal to N1RT, for final state PV2 is equal to N2RT. Substituting these values for PV2 and PV1 in this equation, we can write delta H is equal to delta U plus N2RT minus N1RT. Now what is the common in this bracket? RT is common, therefore delta H is equal to delta U plus N2 minus N1 RT, and this N2 minus N1 is a change in number of moles, delta N. So N2 minus N1 is equal to delta N, and we can write delta H is equal to delta U plus delta NRT. This is the relation between heat of reaction at constant pressure and at constant volume for a given chemical reaction. Now see how the work done can be calculated. If N2 is greater than N1, N2 is greater than N1, so what will happen? What is the answer of delta N? Is it positive or negative? This is positive. First condition, when N2 is greater than N1, therefore delta N will be equal to positive. This factor is positive. And there is RT. So delta H is equal to delta U plus certain positive factor is added. If secondly N2 is less than N1, at that time delta N will be negative. And at that time this factor since it comes negative, this sign will be negative, means there is the subtraction. This is how the relation between heat of reaction at constant pressure and at constant volume for a given chemical reaction can be obtained. Now let us see the work done during a chemical reaction. Work done during chemical reaction. Work done during chemical reaction. So just now we have studied the equation dW. We know the equation for work done, dW will be equal to minus P delta V. Therefore dW will be equal to minus P delta V is nothing but P2 minus P1. Solving the bracket, we can write dW is equal to minus PV2. Bracket we are solving. See, here is a negative sign. Now bracket I am solving. Negative sign I have carried. So PV2 minus PV1. And again we know ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT. Therefore, PV2 will be equal to N2RT. Later, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. And PV1 will be equal to N1RT. For initial state, this is the equation for ideal gas. PV1 is equal to N1RT. For final state at constant pressure, PV2 is equal to N2RT. Substituting PV2 and PV1, that is substituting equation 2 and equation 3. In equation number 1, what we will get, we can write dW will be equal to minus, this is the minus sign, PV2, PV2 means N2RT minus PV1, that is PV1 N1RT. Now taking the common, again dW will be equal to minus, sign is there, then in N2 minus N1, N2 minus N1, what is common, RT is common, therefore we can write work done will be equal to minus delta NRT during the chemical reaction. During a chemical reaction, work done dW will be equal to minus delta nRT. Now see the important points. What is delta N? Delta N will be equal to N2 minus N1. Now let, if N2 is greater than N1, what happens? If N2 is greater than N1, therefore delta N will be positive. So if N2 is greater than N1, this delta N is positive. And what is work done? dW, is it positive or negative? Since delta N is positive, positive multiplied by negative, it is the negative. So this is the negative work, that is nothing but work of expansion. Whenever number of moles of gaseous product is greater than that of the number of moles of gaseous reactant, change in number of moles delta N is positive. So positive substituted here, delta N is positive, this whole figure will be positive, multiplied by negative, the answer will be negative, means work done is negative, and that is the process of expansion. Expansion of gas take place because change in number of moles is positive, and that is the work done by system to surrounding. Work is done by system to the surrounding whenever this is the condition. Secondly, if N2 is less than n1. Now n2 is less than n1. So what is this answer? Delta n, delta n. Now n2 is less, n1 is greater. So n2 minus n1, is it positive or negative? Now this is negative. Since delta n, now it is negative. This factor is negative. So this total answer comes negative and negative multiplied by negative. So here del dw work done will be positive. So is it work done? Of compression or expansion, now positive means it is the work of compression. Can you tell me whether the work of compression is work done by system to surrounding or surrounding to system? That is the work done by surrounding onto the system. And third case, whenever n2 is equal to n1, number of moles of gaseous product is equal to number of moles of gaseous reactant, at that time change in number of mole delta n will be equal to zero. This is zero, and anything multiplied by zero will be zero. Therefore no work will be done whenever there is no change in the number of moles of reactant and product taking place. If the number of moles of gaseous reactant is equal to the number of moles of gaseous product, that is n2 is equal to n1, at that time change in number of moles will be equal to 0, and 0 substituted over here, this whole factor becomes 0. Neither work of expansion nor work of compression is obtained in this process. Net work done will be 0. So that is there about the negative or positive or zero work obtained during a chemical reaction. See it once again. Work done during process is given by the equation. This is that equation, dW will be equal to minus P delta V. It is the work done in a process. Minus P delta V. Delta V is nothing but V2 minus V1. Final volume minus initial volume. Negative sign I am carrying as it is. Minus in bracket T V2 minus V1. Solving this big bracket I am solving. So it becomes PV2 minus PV1. Negative sign is there. But in ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. For initial state and final state, it is written as PV2 is equal to N2RT and PV1 is equal to N1RT. PV2 minus PV1. So N2, this PV2 replaced by N2RT. PV1 is replaced by N1RT. And we can get N2RT minus N1RT. So this equation will be dW is equal to minus in bracket N2RT minus N1RT. Now what is common? RT is common. Therefore dW will be equal to minus N2 minus N1 RT. This is nothing but delta L and RT. So dW is equal to minus delta L RT, where delta L is N2 minus N1. N2 is greater than N1. At that time what happened? Delta N will be positive, and this is positive, so answer comes to be negative. That is the work of expansion. It is a work of expansion because negative work, that is work done by system to the surrounding. On the other hand, if N2 is less than N1, at that time delta N will be negative. If delta N is negative, negative into negative, now it becomes positive. Therefore work done is positive. That is known as work of compression, or that is the work done by surrounding to system. And whenever number of moles of gaseous reactant and gaseous product are same, N2 is equal to N1, change in number of moles is 0. Number of moles of gaseous reactant and product are same, at that time this is 0. So whole factor comes 0, means no work will be done. when ever there is no change in number of moles of gaseous reactant and product take place, and the net work done in chemical reaction will be zero at that time. This is how three different type of work can be obtained during a chemical reaction, either negative or positive or zero, based on the work done in a chemical, in a process.